With strategic modeling, you can model different business outcomes that are calculated based on different sets of forecast assumptions. You do this by creating scenarios. When you define your scenarios, you specify the accounts to include the entire chart of accounts, a subset of accounts, or a single account. The base scenario contains every account. You add an account to a scenario because you want the values to come from your new scenario rather than from the base scenario or other standalone scenario. You can create additional scenarios to conduct what-if analysis. Let's say you have one forecast in a high-growth scenario with optimistic assumptions and another forecast in a low-growth scenario with a more pessimistic set of assumptions. You can create these on-the-fly scenarios within each model to quickly evaluate data based on your assumptions. You can then combine scenarios from different models to create a blended consolidation scenario, which is called a business case. You can evaluate how key metrics are affected for the high and low growth scenarios, and then compare your results. Let's take a look at a report and evaluate the data within different scenarios. In this report, we can review data for the base scenario. After we change the scenario to upside case, we can see how our assumptions in upside case impact key metrics such as shareholder value. When you create a new scenario, you create it from an existing scenario. The properties and account selections are based on the currently active scenario, which in this case is upside case. You can enter scenario-specific values for the selected accounts. By default, strategic modeling includes two default scenarios. The base scenario includes all accounts and contains the original inputs of each account. It does not inherit any values from any other scenario. The actual scenario contains actual data. Let's create a scenario. Give the scenario a name and description. Determine if the new scenario will be an inheriting or standalone scenario. In this case, we'll create an inheriting scenario, which will inherit values and forecast methods from upside case. All scenarios inherit the input values from the accounts in the base scenario or other standalone scenario unless you specify an input value in that scenario. Let's add some accounts to our scenario. Values for the accounts we did not select will be inherited from a standalone scenario, such as base. If you no longer need a scenario, you can delete it. When you delete a scenario, all the data for that scenario is also deleted. We can see here that we have multiple scenarios within the same model. To change a scenario's characteristics, edit it by clicking the scenario. In the point of view bar, select a scenario to review data for that scenario. After calculating the high growth scenario, we see updated account data for that scenario. Accounts from upside case are also displayed since we selected upside case as the scenario from which high growth inherits. Since high growth was created based on the base scenario, the unit volume, product price, and product sales data is the same as the data in the base scenario. So, to start, unit volume for 2025 for both base and high growth is over 20 million, and product sales for 2025 for both scenarios is a little over 851 million. Since high growth inherits logic and data from upside case, the logic and data for those inherited accounts is also in our high growth scenario. For example, cost of goods sold is calculated as a percentage of sales. For both the upside case and the high growth scenarios, the value is over 66%. We can change the data for unit volume or product price within the high growth scenario to calculate product sales for high growth because we added those specific accounts when we created that scenario. Before we enter data for the high growth scenario, let's take a look at the income statement based on the price from the base scenario and the logic from the upside case scenario. This is our cost of goods sold. Now I'll enter values in the high growth scenario. After saving and calculating, we can return to the income statement and see the impact on cost of goods sold. You can make it easier to find commonly used scenarios by changing the scenario order. This also changes the order in the point of view bar. I will move high growth so it is listed close to the top. Base and actual cannot be reordered and are always the first and second scenarios in the list. Here you can see the updated scenario order. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.